What's up, everybody? welcome. Today I'm adding some secret tunnels to the Overworld. I'm excited to do this. Always wanted some secret tunnels. So, secret tunnels. These are gonna go. What's this one? Butter. Let's look at Xanadu. Back to my default world here. Alright, so secret tunnels. I'm thinking one of them will be placed down here in this region. Another one will be up here. Another one will be somewhere in here. And this last one will be up here. And this one will link to here, back and forth. So if you can find this secret tunnel, you'll be able to walk yourself all the way to the other side of the Overworld, which is great because when you're on the Overworld, you're exploring, you're having a good time, you're listening to the music, you're fighting enemies, you're just discovering things, maybe even secrets, dungeons. You find this secret. This is findable, where you can go from here and just magically goes all the way over here. It doesn't even make sense. It doesn't even make spatial sense. It's only going to be like one room long. You go down in here, and there'll be one room you go over, and you come back up, and you're over here. I love video games. You can get away with weird stuff like that. But playing with people's a sense of space in the game. The virtual space, I guess. Did I start this thing? We're rolling. All right, let's do this. I'm gonna need to actually go down to the level of the world generator to make this happen. So, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn off the whole maze. So it'll look something like this. This is what it looks like at first now. This is since yesterday. I added this new thing where it predetermines the location of dungeons and then changes them later once it knows the difficulty of each path to get to it. But anyways, it knows where all the dungeons are going to be in general and knows where all the gates are going to be. So this is the view before it places the maze. And it's got like its placement of all the dungeons and it's placed all its gate locations. But this is something meta, like these secrets, where you can go from one side of the world to the other. These require a little bit of pre-thought. They need to be pre-located, right? They can't be on a gate location. They can't be overriding a dungeon location. Do I want them to be about over here and over there and over there and over there? And, what else? Oh, they also need to drop a water. I'm actually going to make these waterfalls. So I love the waterfall. And it's a really nice pattern because it can change its width based on the random numbers that are in that that area. And so I want to do some more waterfalls. Like if, let's draw it. Like if the waterfall was like, or the, you know, the portal is going to be right here. And say it warps to like this side or something. You know, this is the portal. They would have to draw a waterfall right here too. So just like right up here, this is a waterfall and that's a waterfall. We'll draw a waterfall here and maybe even a lake beneath it or something like that. But especially just this waterfall. So because it has to do that, these need to be marked. Like these are actually, these two little quadrants and these two little quadrants are marked beforehand, before everything else, with non-traversable flags. So that when the maze generates itself, it's not going to generate a maze portion that's right above a waterfall, which as you can see, when you add the whole world back in, it did not actually... It didn't actually draw any of the maze right there, or right there, or as you can see, in the lakes as well. So anyways, the waterfall is a special thing, so I'll actually draw a reserved area right there for each one of these little portals. So it's going to change the way the mazes turn out. But since I'm already doing all this stuff to change the mazes right now, I figure let's just go big and do all the cool stuff I wanted to do. Like these awesome portals that take you all the way across the world. You can just find... Oh, it's going to be sweet. But especially sweet because sometimes it sucks when you play Songbringer and you get to the... You explore yourself all the way over to the side. This side of the world, you've got like so far... And then you have to go walk your ass all the way back. That sucks. Why not find these portals? And you're like, wow, now I'm all the way on the other side. It's so cool because now you're exploring new stuff. Okay, so that's kind of a lengthy intro to what we're working on today. But I wanted to give that before I start coding and things get a little more cerebral. All right, so this is going to be in the maze generator. I'm actually just going to close the buffers. I'm not using these right now. All right, so the first thing we want to do is reserve a few more waterfalls, randomly choose some positions and stuff like that. I've got a function already that I'm using currently for where it places dungeons, and it actually looks up all the positions according to a certain style. Or is that it? Is that how it works? Anyways, it's at the end of generate overworld pre, which is right after this. And this is, yeah, we're going to have to do this inside an knew dungeons. I've got a couple different compiler switches for now, so I can go back and forth between the old dungeon layout or old overworld and the new overworld temporarily. When I finally finish this beta update, I'll take all the old code out. But it's good to have that as a reference point. Each time I change the world, I kind of want to look back at the old worlds and go, oh, yeah, I forgot that this changed and this is why it's better and stuff. Just compare A, B. Yeah, so the way that this dungeons works, it actually lists the possible dungeons. I don't want to do something like this. Oh, excuse me. I got it. All right, so yeah, we want to do something similar to this. I'll put this up here. Oh, yo, what's up, HD? Almost, man, I'm feeling better. I'm definitely feeling better than I was a couple days ago. How you doing, man? What's up? So we're going to call this place... portals, tunnels, let's call these tunnels. Tunnels that criss-cross the overworld. All right, so now I got it wrapped in this nice little convenient compiler thing so I can switch it on or off. All right, so I want to list the possible places, right? So we were just talking about that. These are going to be the possible places over here in this corner, that corner, that corner, that corner, all the corners. So really, you just want to look for if it's I guess, first of all, we'll check if its distance is within this rectangle, and then we'll check if it's just not that part of the rectangle. All right, and then it also can't be near a gate and stuff like that. Okay, so must be near a corner. Oh, you did? Oh, sorry, man. I'm not very active on Facebook. So, yeah, you're starting to figure things out. Sweet, man. That you mention it, I'll go check my Facebook later on. Sorry, I don't check my Facebook that often. I check Twitter all the time, though. Like on Twitter every day. Manhattan distance from this point to one of the corners. So we'll just give it like a corner X, corner Y. Nice, man. Right on. Corner X is going to be if start X is less than or equal to size X. Half of size X, right? Then corner X is gonna be one or size X minus two. There we go. All right, so there, that's the corner X, right? So if the corner X is, if the X though is less than the middle point, right? It's going to use x1. If it's greater than the midpoint, it uses this x. Basically the same thing for corner y. So if the star y is less than or equal to, no, star y, no, sorry. If the x so if the Manhattan distance from the corner x, corner y. Oh, we can't do Manhattan distance. We have to do individual. So if the abs of x minus corner x is less than or equal to one, and the abs of, yeah, fast travel tunnels, right? Isn't that exciting? Finally, you'll be able to like stumble across these things that take you all the way across the overworld so quickly. Woo! It'll be like an amusement park ride. Only it's like it's not really an amusement park. Yeah, right. I'm excited to make this. I'm really excited by the new world generator stuff. This is version 12 of the world generator, and it has some sweet ass features. It places the gates at lots smarter locations. So as you can see, like this first level is like got a lot of gates that are nice and spread out. I know, right? It's fun to play, but it's also really fun. It's gonna make exploring the world a little bit more fun because you're not gonna get stuck in the corners, right? Or on the edges. So if you wander your ass all the way across to this side of the map, you can easily find two different ways, or not easily, maybe it's gonna be secret, kinda, but you will be able to find two different ways to warp your ass all the way to the other side. So walking that far wasn't quite as in vain, you know? You don't have to walk your ass way back this way if you want needed to go whatever that side. What's up, Carrot? Yeah, I'm really looking forward to this. I'm also going to, for this next update, I'm also going to be making some cool changes to the way the NPCs approach you all at first. Like the first, or not even the NPC, but the first mini boss guy, the drop guy that throws the boomerang style horn, that guy, he's going to be in a smart, much smarter location. Right now, you kind of like have to stumble across him, and he's random, which is kind of cool, but I've got a really good idea for how to place him at a really like important clutch point of the story where you have to basically come through this point of the game, and he'll have his own pattern and stuff like that too. So the actual level of the screen he's on will have its own unique feel, and it'll be pretty fun. That Reaper taking you underground, it's funny. I thought of actually making a little boatman you get on his boat, and he goes over like one screen, and then you get off the boat. But for now, it's just going to be a simple little tunnel for today's stream. Hopefully, that's the goal. If I can get it to place these tunnels and then create little areas in the actual world where the tunnels go from there to there, and then play it on the game, that's today's goal. I think I can do that in 2 hours. All right, so yeah, so if the abs of y minus the corner y is also less than or equal to 1. So that'll keep it inside that rectangle. A fact-telling boatman? Okay, so yeah, you can be on a gate. Can't have non-traversable? Is that right? Let's think about this. Right. We are going to be placing a waterfall, so we can't place a waterfall where it has non-traversable. Can it have a gate too there? Yeah, it can have gates too there because you'll be able to, right? If you were gating into a waterfall area, yeah, I don't think we need this. Let's just comment it out for now. I'm all worried, like, I'm gonna lose this. Okay, so now we're pushing back a bunch of possible. We're not going to do this based on dungeon styles. We don't need to track dungeons. So now we've got a list of possible positions. We don't need to assert this. We need to definitely assert that. Oh, you know what? Kind of want to do this. Yeah, actually, this should be a for loop. We'll just do a for loop first time. We'll do each quadrant. Oh, do for each quadrant. All right, so for each quadrant Q. So that way we've got the southwest quadrant, the northwest quadrant, northeast, south, north, whatever. All right, and then it'll know its corner X, corner Y based on the quadrant. I think I've got a function for this, get quadrant X. No, not get quadrant. I think it's offset quadrant X. That gives you -1 or 1. Oh, it's quadrant and X. What's up, Arcane? How's it going, man? So the corner X. This is just easier to do it this way now. If the quadrant is K southwest or the quadrant is K northwest, we're doing one. And then otherwise, it's just, yeah, size x minus 2. Then corner Y is if we are southwest or southeast. Nice. Cool, man. I'm making some tunnels here for the overworld. So these tunnels will go from like, you'll go be able to go from all the way on this side of the map, all the way over to this side of the map with these tunnels. Right, so if it's in the south quadrants, it's one. Otherwise, it's size y minus 2. Size y is like 8, 7, 6. Yeah, that's one in, and then that's one in. So we got corner x, corner y. So for each quadrant, it fills up a different possible list. It does for each size x, size y, computes all that, checks its flags, checks its non-traversable, pushes back its positions. We just need to make sure that for each quadrant, the possible that's possible is just not empty. Possible is empty. That's a world error. Not enough possible. Overworld tunnel positions. Salad dogs, what's up? Yes. It's going good, man. Yeah, it'll be a loop. It will be a loop. You will always be able to find a tunnel from one side to the other. Let's start over, huh? Let's start over on this little whole like mess of yellow lines. Right? So the tunnel will be approximately like right. There's we let's try with X's, huh? There's one tunnel there, one tunnel here, and these go between each other. And then there'll be a tunnel approximately here and here, and same thing. Okay, so we've listed possible positions. Now we just got to choose one at random each time. So we'll choose. We'll choose one of the positions if possible. We'll use this, the maze generators get rand x0, y0. I is going to be what quadrant this is. Oh, and then mod possible dot size. Okay, so there, we've selected one of the positions at random without using a random index, by the way, which is a nice way to do it because it kind of predetermines which random number you're going to use based on your world seed a lot more clearly. If you end up changing the rand index, it's a nice way to do it too because it changes the way all the rest other random numbers get chosen and stuff. But when it comes to things like this, where you kind of want it to be the same random choice each time, random determinism. It's a fun topic. Okay, so we've selected our point. All right, now we just need to mark this as a waterfall. So We want to set the non-traversable set traverse squared for pause. Let's call this P actually. I like shorter variable names for common things. P.x squared. P.y. Not squared. Times 2. P dot y times 2. Those two plus 0 right there, so it's a little, kind of just repeat this pattern here. That's plus 1. Set it, set the direction traversed. Oh, what direction do the other waterfalls do it? Waterfall. Oh, we set flag waterfall too. Gosh, I need to make this a freaking function. All right, let's just do it. I'll make a function called set waterfall. Give it an x2, y, well, no, just an xy. All right. Function in maze, it'll be a private function. Set waterfall. This is kind of a maze gen function. So we'll keep it here in the maze. I think I got a few of these functions up here at the top. Oh, dang myself. It's going slow today. Why so slow? All right, so let's make this XY waterfall. This one is also just X now. This can be a const. This is Y. There, we got a nice set waterfall function. What did I do wrong here? Maze 1066 expected. What? Oh. So anyways, all right. So where we're doing this, we also set a waterfall. And now we're not coupling any code. We have a cohesive. We have achieved cohesive fit cohesiveness. I know, right? I love it. What I need to figure out next with Vim. Still got errors here. I want to be able to do this. Like, I've got one little keystroke where I go GF to open up a file. Or wait, no. I got a different one. I'll go GL to go to the thing underneath the current, like, you know what I mean? I used to go to I want to do that, right? But that doesn't work for local variables. So if I'm using a local variable, like, let's find a local variable. Sand pause. Here. If I want to go to this local variable and I do GL, it can't go to it because it's not a tag. But the GD command does. So I want to be able to learn how to make it so if one command fails, I can do a different command. And that will really, really improve my Vim workflow. Ooh, right, nice. Right, yeah, you could do whatever you want. Whatever you want with just a keystroke or two. Yeah, yeah, there's got to be a way to do this in Vim. I'll find it. I think what I'll have to do is write a function in my VimRC. I think I've already got some Vim... some functions in here. One of them doesn't work. Here's one, my replace. I think this is the one that doesn't work. But basically you can write commands and then like, you know, assign a keystroke to that command or whatever. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah, I think they do. Or maybe there's ways to express them with a return value or not. I don't know. I got to look more deeply into this and I got to understand how to write these functions and stuff. And I'm sure I can write something that's like, oh, do this or that. You know, that's all I wanted to do. Oh, so where was I? Oh, right, setting waterfalls and stuff and got errors still. Oh, no errors now? Now it's just like no errors. All right, cool. Well, let's see if it still works, huh? What world am I doing? I need to be doing Xanadu. These are some world scenes I was doing this morning. Let's back up. Oh, yeah? Isn't it? Right, it's really weird. Can you tell me more about how it's weird? Is it, don't you like, isn't everything like a send call? Like everything is a calls and it's like, is it asynchronous too or something? So So we want to be Xanadu. We want to see the overworld. We don't want to do all the seeds. Doesn't matter where. All right, see what we got so far. I'm trying to place four waterfall. Oh, what? Oh, it worked. Nice. It worked on the first try. It worked on the first try. It never worked on the first try. Apparently it worked on the first try. Let's take a screenshot of that and see how it compares to the old Xanadu from 6 hours ago. There's old Xanadu. There's new Xanadu. Right? What? What if I just fade it out a little, huh? Okay, so things definitely changed. Definitely changed a lot of the maze. Which is totally to be expected when you're doing something like this. Just adding some waterfalls. Ooh, this one's got a store. Dude, this actually looks pretty fun. Let's go. All right, cool. I'm excited. Let's go try this out. Woo! Okay, so I want to be... Let's start the world off here, right here at 000. What does this like world look like now with these extra waterfalls? Now we just got to throw some tunnels between them. Whoops. Waterfall! So glad there's more of you now! Now we just need a secret! Something was magic about how I did the placement of the other waterfalls. Maybe I just didn't. I ignored the fact that these. I think those need to be. Yeah, anyways, that's a touch up thing. Okay, cool. So the next thing to do is to go and put a door there and an entrance into a cave. And then the cave is a tunnel, and the tunnel leads to the other side of the world. Oh, sorry, the music was kind of loud, huh? Oh, it's weird on a fundamental level. Everything you do breaks down into S expressions. Oh, atoms and lists. Huh. Huh. Immutable, huh? Everything's immutable? All your variables are immutable? Wow. Oh, right. I should check one thing. Before I do that, I should check and make sure if I don't do the new waterfalls. Right, if it just selects some points but then doesn't use them. Huh. Wow. It's a fascinating language. Is this the old, okay, so I'm going to take a screenshot here and make sure this is the old one. Like, that I didn't ruin it by adding that new set waterfall function. Oh. Oh. Okay, it did swap. Just did, all it did was it swapped the color right there. And that might just be the way the scene is. But other than that, the whole world is exactly the same. All right, good, good, good. Okay, so that's worthy of being checked in. But like this. Set flag waterfall at X, Y. XX2 is X plus I. X squared plus I, or X, 2X. Okay, and that's, yep. 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 Okay. Oh, really? That's interesting. So variables are just symbols that basically are functions that return a value you tell them to store. Right? So, but if everything is an atom that's immutable, so how does it store a variable that it changes? Oh, does it create a new atom every time it's got a new value for this for its? Huh. Oh, wow. Man. It's interesting. Cool, and I'm gonna get rid of that code that I know I don't need. Oh, and one other thing. When you're changing the world, you gotta make sure it doesn't like introduce any crazy amount of retries to the world. Luckily, man, I made this awesome improvement to the dungeon generator today that if it fails a dungeon generating, it tries 10 more times with the same world seed for that dungeon before it gives up. So it's so much better. Look at this. They're all zero retries still. Yeah, so adding these four waterfalls to the world did not mess anything up. This is amazing. They're all still zero. There's one. There's one. But one retry is so doable. And I could probably fix a few of these one retries as well. So I pretty much looked at all the zero retries. These are mostly zero. So I'm going to focus now on looking at the maps as they come by. And I just want to see the waterfalls and like see where it placed them all and like see if maybe I can catch one that that just doesn't look right. Actually, these are all looking fine so far. Yeah, because a waterfall creates those non-traversable bits. Ooh, wait a minute. It did. Actually, yeah, third. That's cool. There's like a cluster of waterfalls in a couple of those worlds there. That was neat. Whoa, that one did light forest for the top of it. These are weird, some of them. Such interesting worlds. These will be really fun to play. Gosh, this adds a really nice element to everything. These little waterfall locations. And waterfalls are cool anyways. Okay, good, good, good. So it does return an atom. Yeah. Singly linked. Oh, really? Everything is a singly linked list, huh? Yeah, you like that? That's a pretty nice little bit too, huh? What it does is it actually, the biomes actually bleed into each other. And that's one of the, it's such a cool thing because what it does is the gate positions were at borders. You're like, oh, there's probably going to be a gate here because it's right at the border. But since the styles now kind of like bleed into each other right after after it's generated its maze and stuff like that, and everything is all set, it's put all its positions and everything, then it just goes back and it changes the styles a little bit. And that's really cool because it creates unexpected things. You're like, oh, I wouldn't have expected a gate would be right here, but it seems like it works really well because it does work really well because they'd actually generated it that way. Yeah, and it adds a more subtle transition too, because you're not like, oh, there's the edge of this biome and a gate. It's like, oh, this is a nice. This is what? I need some water. Be right back. Don't know why the phrase stark tundra made me laugh, but it did. Okay, this is ready to be checked in. I like it. I like it. Okay, phase one complete. The next things, there can't be stores. So I need to prevent the stores from placing themselves on these waterfalls. So, anyways, the waterfalls right now, they set flag waterfall. I also wanted to do a flag number. Nice, right on. Thanks for saying that. Need to work on it a little bit more. The little thing at nighttime when you sometimes see that circle or that oval at nighttime, it's like it bugs some people. So I might work on it, like maybe, I don't know. It was just an accident. I thought it was a pleasant accident, but some people don't think it's a good thing. So we'll do K flag one, shift it up the quadrant. That's it. So each one of these waterfalls has a number. What's up, Kukuriku? Nice. Does it change when I move around? Wire patterns? Is it wire? Where? So anyways, I need to make sure that the stores don't place themselves on these special waterfalls. So let's go to where it places the stores. Place stores. So I think this is where it has some logic for like... Yeah. I think we want to go play store and like play some logic in here about it. Can't, it doesn't have a flag number yet. All right. Ichni, it's cool. Oh, it's Moire? Yeah. You're on Windows today? What you doing on Windows? So if get flag number for this point, oh wait, no, this get flags, no, if the flag number is 0. Oh really? Whoa. Oh, sweet. You have a Mac on 2 monitors and a 3rd one. Can I do a Windows PC? Oh, dude, that sounds so cool. Whoa, dude. Sounds so futuristic. I gotta try it. It sounds so sci-fi. So wait, can get flag number return 0? Or 0. Yeah, I can return 0. Good job. There. Okay, so there were a couple worlds there where it was placing stores in the waterfalls. Shoot, you know what? Let's actually check this. Let's do it like that. So I'll comment what I just did out. Right? Yeah. And then I'll loop and find a world that has the problem. What's up, bulldozer? This is C++, man. All right, so let me let's find the world first. Let's just run it like it was. Find the world with a store on one of these new waterfalls. Whoops, what's this bug? What's this, bugs? What? Nice, right on. You're learning to see the hard way. Cool. I've heard that book's good. Oh, P-Dot. P-Dot X, P-Dot Y. Thank you. I can't read the errors when they're in this tiny little window here on the right. Gotta remember to like run. Okay, wait. Gotta pay attention. Find a waterfall with the store on it. I thought I saw one here on the left a while ago. Oh, there. Who's that last one? Right before vagina. Which is zebras. Okay, zebras, you're the one. So we need mega seed. Zebras. Right? Let's make sure that's the one. Yes, good. We got that top left waterfall with a plus sign, which means it's a store up there. So that thing, let's verify that this new fixie fix works. Oh, Mega Seed is the world seed. It's from way long, at the very beginning of the whole game, I called it Mega Seed. And then I was like, wait, it's more like a world seed. So it's called a world seed when you're playing the game and it's like talking to you and stuff. It says, give me a world seed. But the mega seed is what I originally named the variable. There's a lot of things like that still. And there's like acid is called poison in the code, even though it's called acid in the game. Okay, so let's re-enable this. Just make sure that now there's no longer a store up in that top left waterfall. You like that? Awesome. Good. It can still place stores in the two waterfalls that are above the lakes. But now we've got a clean slate. All these waterfalls are ready for the tunnels now. Okay, so waterfall tunnels have flag numbers. Oh, yeah? Nice, man. Nice. All right, so what's next? Oh, we want to do the tunnels. Yes. Okay, so what I need is some Z levels to connect to for these. I'm thinking like a whole dedicated level for these would be good. Right? Because there's a whole bunch of Z levels in the game. It's like, you know, Z level 0 is the overworld. Z level negative 1 is the sword cave. Negative 2 is like the first store. I'm thinking it's a good idea actually to put, to give it its own Z. Because there's interest Zs. Let's look at the Zs. Yeah, there's interest Z's, underground entrance Z's, sacred Z's, trip Z's. See, interest Z's might be possible. No. That'd be a bad idea. Extra Z's. Trip Z's are the latest ones I just added. Let's do it. The longer I stare at this, it's just not going to happen. Okay, first tunnel Z equals K first trip Z minus K num trips. Does it have a num trips? Oh, world max trips. Let's call this an overworld tunnel, just to distinguish it. So this will be max overworld tunnels. And there's only two of them. Okay, and then this is really important too. The world min z now is k first overworld tunnel z minus k world max overworld tunnels. Okay, so we need to make sure everywhere that I did K first trip Z. Just to make sure that there's nothing else really fundamental or important I need to change here. Oh, a constants method would be really nice. If it, like, is trip. Is overworld tunnel. First overworld tunnel Z, K world max overworld tunnels. Okay, so I used it there in his trip. I used it also there in his trip. Here, these are the most important ones. Trip Z is secret Z minus world max secrets. Overworld tunnel Z is trip Z minus max trips. And then the other important one up here is this, the overworld tunnel, or no way. The world min Z, which is now world min Z is first overworld tunnel minus max overworld tunnels. This links you into the first trip Z. Ooh, yeah. These assertions are really nice. Is overworld tunnel Wait, the secret was checking the trip Z. Oh. This should be his trip. And what are we checking here? This is the interest checks the next thing, the secrecy. The secret checks the next thing, the tripsy. The tripsy checks the next thing, the overworld. There. Cool. Now we got a sanity check. And where do we place these patterns? Ah, here we go. Actually, I should probably put something in here like this, like for in the I. So each style key, okay, first, overworld, tunnel, minus I. These are just caves for now. We want to create them all. So these are two wide, it's a three wide actually, 3x1. Cool. Next I want to make sure the maze generator will make sure the shape of this is nice. This is either extra long tunnels. You go in one, you go through a whole room, and then down through another one. So the maze generator, we're talking about the generate method. Just generate, not dungeon generate, not Portland noise generate. Maze generate, oh, at the end of this method, we got size X is 3, size Y is 1. Yeah, we haven't ever done this before. But it's kind of like this T for the caves. Actually, yeah. Let's just keep it with if size Y is 1. Let's make that logic good because I don't think I've ever done this before where. Yeah, let's make this one smarter. So for each X, it goes and sets the opening. So I think we just want two. Oh, after we do, I think this is right. Let's set to play it. Set open. So we want 0 and size x minus. Minus 1. Okay. Southeast, south, I guess. Oh, right in the thing we were at before. Start X. Oh yeah, start can be 0, 0. Okay, that's cool. Whoops, just quit. Whoops. All right, so next we're gonna, so we've got the Z levels, we've got the shape for those Z levels, the tunnels, we've got the entrance point for the tunnels. We need to actually trigger the exit point from the waterfall to the tunnel. Let's do that. I guess that's in create mazy. For waterfall. There's pattern waterfall. Okay, now if we have a flag number. If n is greater or equal to 1 and n is less than or equal to k world max over world tunnels, then we place an exit destination from here to the overworld tunnel, and also, so yeah, from here to the overworld tunnel. So exit dest is gonna be, we'll just set it. That's, oh, if this is this P, yeah, we're in create mazy. So this is P.x. P.x is less than, the maze width? Do we not know that at this point? Whatever. Maze.get size x. Then the exit dest is always going to be x0. Otherwise, it's 3, 2. I don't know, is it? It's been down a couple times lately. P.y is going to be very similar. Oh, this is the Z actually. So this is always Y0. The Z is K first overworld tunnel Z minus PWI is the lower half. Oh, this is just 0 or 1. So there, we should have our exit destination set correctly. Now we need to look up the area. At exit de Oh wait, is this area guaranteed? Which what kind of area is this I'm trying to get? Yeah, it's just area set exit dest. So our exit destination needs a its exit destination set back to us, which is P. Okay, well, cross your fingers. Let's see if this works. If this does work, we'll have a freaking tunnel. All right, man. Unwind. See ya. Cheers, brother. Forgot to recompile in the background. And there was a bug. There wasn't a bug. What? All right, let's see what happened. Do we have the exit destination from this waterfall to the tunnel? Does the tunnel have the right shape? What's going on here? Why is it just not running? Oh, did I break something? Invalid area. Okay, I messed something up there. Let's find out what. Okay, we got a couple breakpoints set. What is this one? 14:00. What? Oh, I haven't even, I guess I haven't seen the Overworld. I need a picture of the Overworld while we're doing this. Let's get that. Oh, what? What? Is this Mega Seed Zebras? Still? There, Xanadu. Take a picture. It'll last longer. Good. It just moved to the location of some stores. Right, so there's our new Xanadu. Okay, we should be getting 14-1. Actually, 1-0 will be the first one it gets. So let's turn this back on. Figure out why that we're getting an assertion failure. Probably I set the exit designation wrong. Oh wait, we create the overworld first, so I might need to call area guaranteed right here. Okay, so this one is at 100, and we've got an exit destination of 00, -76. But I think area is gonna bail because it's like, oh, it's the blank area. Yep. Okay, yeah, that was it. All right, I think we need to call area guaranteed right here. No, there's no guaranteed. Thought there was a guaranteed function. Oh, it's just area guaranteed. Right, and I'm doing the same thing here with these overworld interests and stores. That's what I was doing wrong. Okay. Just let that run, let that fly. Come on, give me some tunnels, man. Running out of steam. The world still generated? That's good. Okay. Do we have an exit desk? Yes, 00, -76. Can we get into. Ooh, wait, what's this? Is this what. Oh, I think it. Wait, did it work? Yeah, 00, -76. But why was it just open like that? It shouldn't be open down there either. Here. Does this work? Can we go out of this? Oh, it's blocked off. This is a funny cave. It didn't put its stuff behind the waterfall. I want to do that. There's a few little things wrong with it, but it worked. I went from one side of the world to the other. Yes. This is so sick. Let's go try it on the one up here. wasn't there. Where was it? Yeah, here we go. Where is this one? Secret entrance here. I don't know where this one is. It's got a weird little rock thing here too, like blocks your way. Well, that's a mystery. Rocket Bunny, what's up? Yeah, right? 80 seconds. Your day's been rough? Why's that, buddy? Why is this, man? Okay, first things first. We want to put the... the waterfall pattern needs to place its stairs behind the waterfall for these. Oh wait, we were actually doing pretty good. This should be checked in so far. Let's make sure this, yeah, this is some pretty fundamental things. Let's get this in one commit. Atomic commits. Check my work here. Overworld tunnel Z. First overworld tunnel minus max overworld tunnel is minus one. Less than that, greater than or equal to max. Two overworld tunnels, trip C minus max trips. World min is overworld tunnel minus max overworlds. Overworld tunnel. We want to make sure that the first overworld tunnel is not a trip. Okay, these openings here, these need to be worked on. Math teacher. Whoa, man. Oh. Huh, wow. Sounds like you got a wild math teacher there. There you go. It's actually probably teaching you a lot just to make you do your own. Right? Oh, wait. What are these again? Set openings. X, Y, south, west, north, east. South is true. South is false. Hang on.
See you in a little while.
See you, baby. Wow. Okay, let's see if the tunnel is better now. Should have its north and south openings a little better. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. It didn't work. How the hell do you center the south opening again? Oh. Man. Sounds like you've had a rough day. Oh, no, it's all right. Sometimes you just got a little steam off. So the center openings function, does that? I wonder if this will work. Man, I need to see the open paths. There you go, candy and pizza. Right, so centering the south openings works really weird. This is up this side. Man. That one's centered, that's centered. This path is centered. Oh, but this one has both of these open. The green lines are showing the open paths for the maze that gets generated. I'm setting the open paths in the maze right here, but it's just not, I'm not quite getting it. I guess I could set southwest manually. I guess it's better than having two openings. Okay, I'll fix that later. Let's go work on the important fun parts. Let's turn off this show pass thing. All right, I want to make it so the waterfall pattern places its stairs behind the waterfall. I love the behind the waterfall thing. Really, it rains more there? Well, you're getting like one of the rainiest winters we've had. You know, the West Coast here has had in a long time. We've had dry, dry winters and dry summers for so many years, like 5 years in a row at least. It's been a drought. And so we're finally getting rain, and it's amazing. The whole West Coast is finally wet again. It's been a long time. Oh, right. If this has a store or this waterfall has a flag number, so get a dot get flag number is greater than 0. Ha. Yep. I'm a no to be quoted with the greatest quotes. Right, let's find out if there's yeah. Secret entrance behind the waterfall. That's all I wanted. Yeah. Gotta fix this entrance though. Yes, I love it. You know, I can walk back here, right? There's nothing stopping me from walking back here at all. Nothing! I just warped across the whole world. Did you see that? Did you see me? Did you see me, Mom? Did you see it? Check this one. What? There's nothing. There's nothing. This one's messed up. This doesn't want to go on. There's nothing back here. What about on the other side of the world? These work. Why not? Okay, I'll set my break. I mean, I'll set it set the point here. Thank you, Asheron. Appreciate it, man. All right, so what's stopping this? Okay, let's set a breakpoint in pattern waterfall. So two of the waterfall portals work. One of them not working. All right, so we set a breakpoint here. Well, this will get hit like four time, the third and the fourth time. Third of the four times are the ones we're looking at. So what do we got? This first one should be, we're talking about this one. So that's 1, 0. It'll be there and there and there. Okay, so this one is 1, 0, 0. All right, the next one, 14, 1. The next one is this third one here, 5, 6. That's not right. Oh, 5, 6. Yeah, that's the other waterfalls. Okay, the most important thing I want to check here is the flag number. First one, flag number two. What? Flag number two? Oh, because it's south. Okay, yeah, and the first one's flag number one. Because it's southeast, which is first. Next one's 5-6. This one shouldn't have a flag number. Flag number zero, good. The next one. This one is 7-6, also flag number zero. This one's 1-7 here. Now we're at this one up here. 1-7. What's your flag number, man? Why are you messing up? Why is there no portal? It's flag number three. It's okay. Flag number three is all right. And the next one should be flag number four at 13-7. Yep. Okay, so those flag numbers came out correct. Something else is preventing this from working. Maybe because there's no exit. Okay, so it's the problem lies in the world back where it generated this. What is the waterfall? Here we go. All right, we want. Right? This should be getting. We're getting this like three times. Oh, I probably did this wrong. It's gotta be it. One zero zero, 14-1. Oh, there. This is a problem. I didn't even get what? Why would it not even get to here? Oh, I did max overworld tunnels. There's four different waterfalls. This needs to be times two. That explains it. Just a little too restrictive with that if statement there. Whew, I'm running out of steam. I've been sick this week. I'm probably gonna need to go soon. Let's check if we got into waterfall back here. And there's one other fun thing I want to do before it's all said and done. Yes, it worked. We have another tunnel that goes to the other side of the world. Whoa, where are we? Whoa. Yeah, let's go backwards through the tunnel. Woo, backwards. Cool. If you want to talk binary, I'm game. Who's the Prime Minister of Scandinavia? There's no Prime Minister of Scandinavia. Seems to be the. Let's check what we got done so far, though. This time, we are giving it secret entrances behind the waterfalls. And sort of fix the openings in the dungeon there, and then fix the top ones. Okay, the one thing I want to do next is just to change the style or the mountains or whatever that it does. Convert rocks. What is it called? Oh, there it is. Pattern cave. If it's Vel or if it's Constance is Overworld tunnel for Areopagus.z. There. So that'll come. It'll make nice mountains on the inside, which will look cool. Oh, duh. You got me. You got me. You're trying to illustrate a point. I know. I know. Did that? Was there a bridge there the whole time? I hope there was. Okay, so this should look cooler now. Yay, they look a little cooler. Okay, with some custom patterns, this'll turn out really neat. And I just need to fix this opening here and guarantee that's always gonna work. I might just go with an opening actually like down here to the left or the right, which I did in a different kind of cave. So I'll probably put some water in. Yeah, I'll put some water in here. Maybe I'll even do a secret path down here. I don't know. This will be really fun to play with. I'm so excited about these overworld tunnels. There you go. That's it for today's stream. Thanks for stumping me, Rocky. You got me. So thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I'll probably be back, not tomorrow, but the next day. And I'll be working on something else. I'm excited about these new little updates to Songbringer. It's like making a very much cooler overworld. Just these little things like these portals connecting things. The gates being in better positions. Things are getting pretty cool. So, we'll see you guys. Have a great one.